Hey, it's Andrew Henderson, Nomad Capitalist in Cape Town, South Africa. And here we are, the day of the US election, November 8th. It has been a year and a half in the making since I remember sitting in my penthouse and watching Trump come down the escalator and thinking, this guy is a lunatic and this is never going to work. And it worked. What do I know about the election and politics, right? And it's pretty great because here in Cape Town, South Africa, where I'm at, people are very interested and then seemingly tying themselves to the election results. In the U.S., in Canada, and parts of Europe where people are protesting and saying, don't vote Trump. And all around the world, people have tied themselves to these election results in a way that it's essential to their life and what's going to happen in the world to who wins, what happens next. And this is really a choice that people make to tie themselves to the results of a certain outcome, to a certain election. One of the things that is so great about this lifestyle is the ability to say, I am going to go where I'm treated best, and I don't want to tie myself to who gets elected in one country, certainly if I don't live there, right? If you choose to live in the U.S., then you're tying yourself to that system. And I'm going to shock people and say I would have supported Bernie Sanders. If Bernie Sanders was the guy, I would have voted for Bernie Sanders. Not because I agree with Bernie Sanders on a frickin' thing, at least economically, but because Bernie Sanders is an honest guy. And Bernie Sanders, for all of his talk of saying, hey, let's be Europeans, let's be socialists, is, hey, Europe also has residency-based taxation, so let's let people leave the U.S., and if they leave, they don't want to pay taxes anymore, then that's great. We'll just soak everyone who's still here. You have the choice to participate in the system, and Trump likes to talk about Brexit plus plus as his victory that he foresees will be Brexit plus plus. It'll be the same thing as Brexit. It's the same kind of audience that or voter pool that will vote for Trump. And of course, when you look at what happened post-Brexit, it wasn't great for Brexit, but or for the UK. But who it didn't really hurt was the people that I'm hanging out with and that I'm working with who had diversified outside of the UK financial system and weren't in the UK banking system and weren't holding all of their wealth in pounds and were selling, we have a couple people I'm working with who are selling their UK rental properties because the place is just becoming bad for investors. And so they're getting out of the UK. And so they weren't that negatively affected. They will not have as good of a passport, although it won't be a big change, but they won't be negatively affected. And so you have to decide, do I want to be part of this reality or do I want to be part of my own reality? Personally, I think that for my money as someone who doesn't live in the U.S., Clinton, who cares? She's probably, and I think that Trump is probably too jingoistic for a country that is already jingoistic, and that might not be a good thing to have more nationalism and national pride. I think the U.S. has enough of that. Neither of them are good candidates, but the choice is, if you want to live in the U.S. and deal with either of them, that's one thing. If you want to live outside of the United States, even though there are still a lot of rules for U.S. citizens, you can still exempt yourself from Obamacare. You can still exempt yourself from some of the different rules. Not all of them, certainly, and that's what we talk about on Nomad Capitalist. But whether Trump or Hillary gets elected is not going to influence your decision, or it shouldn't, whether you're going to renounce or whatever you're going to do. If you want to leave, you should leave. And it shouldn't be because of Trump or Hillary. And no doubt our site will be flooded with people tomorrow who, just like after Brexit, are freaked the hell out and are looking for a short-term little sugar high to, feel good about how their guy lost and try and fix the problem. But that's not fixing the problem. The problem is you have to choose to have your own reality that is divorced from the system, that whether you're a U.S. citizen or whether you're a citizen of any other country, that what happens isn't going to change the world, I don't think. The argument is that Trump is going to, launch nuclear weapons or whatever on other countries. I guess that remains to be seen. But for those people who are in favor of capitalism and think that Hillary Clinton is not the most capitalist candidate, you got to put that aside and realize that you can choose to move your money out of U.S. dollars. You can choose to live where you want. You can choose to pay taxes where you want. You can still make all the decisions that you could before. It won't make a difference. And it's not a commentary on the political system. That's a commentary on an extra political decision that you have to make to separate yourself from the system that everyone else just follows blindly. If you do that, that's where the success lies. That's what we talk about a Nomad Capitalist. That's the mindset that you want to get yourself into, election or no election.